So Leanne, we balanced a budget on time this year. Can you tell us about what you like and what you don't like?
So we got a budget on time this year. I wouldn't say that it's truly balanced, though.
Talk about it, please.
So as per our Constitution, the budget is due on June 30th or July 1st of every year. And this is the first year that I've been in office that we've actually seen the budget get done on time. Now, I think there's a correlation between it being an election year and folks being willing to work together more so than in past years. And there are some good things in the budget. We got $100 million more for basic education funding. That is critical to us, especially in Delaware County. We were able to increase pre-K funding by $25 million. We were able to implement a new grant program of $60 million for school safety, because we know this is an issue that parents and communities are really concerned about post-Parkland, post-Sandy Hook. And so those are all positive aspects of this budget. We also increased the Department of Environmental Protection's budget for the first time in a while. They'll be able to hire some new staff positions, and that's critical to us in Delaware County because we need folks who are monitoring pipeline construction and pipeline spills because it's impacting our communities. The bad news, though, is that this budget still borrows money, relies on numbers that aren't fully there. And before I ran for office, I worked with small business owners. And I will tell you, if any of the small business owners who I worked with balanced their budget the way the state does, they'd be bankrupt and probably under IRS investigation at this point. So it's better than we've seen in past years. This is a budget that I've actually voted for. I voted against a number of budgets previous to this, but it still doesn't really fix the problem. And the problem is that we've got a fundamentally unfair tax structure where multinational corporations and the richest of the rich and big oil and gas companies are paying less than the rest of us. And if we really want a sustainable budget that provides real property tax relief, for example, in Pennsylvania, then we need to do the right thing and enact a severance tax, close corporate tax loopholes, and make our tax system fairer for the average family.
So they're even paying less. I know in federal taxes they're paying less, but they're paying less on a state level as well.
So when you talk about corporate taxes, the system is rigged so that if you're an out-of-state multinational corporation, you're able to get out of a lot of things. And there's a procedure called combined reporting, which the governor's been pushing, I've been pushing. It levels the playing field for our small businesses in Pennsylvania, local businesses. We haven't been able to get that enacted yet.